Before starting the production of the two-wheel drive electric bicycle, we will first install the rear hub motor freewheel. We installed 2 BB spacers to adjust the gap. Apply anti-seize grease to the freewheel screw thread. Simply turn it lightly by hand to fit it. To adjust the gap, we use 1 brake rotor spacer. This is a 203 mm floating rotor suitable for heavy-duty bikes. The rotor bolts are tightened in order of the farthest distance. Tighten them to 5 to 6 Newton meters torque. We use washers on the motor axle to adjust the gap. Now, let's install the motor on the swing arm. Secure it with a nut. We temporarily assembled it on the swing arm. We adjusted the distance between the motor and the rotor with washers to make it sufficient. Let's start installing the front hub motor on the frame. We temporarily installed the front motor. There is interference between the front fork and the motor, and it won't fit. Unfortunately, the bolt and brake caliper are touching. We trimmed the protruding bolt. We replaced all the cover bolts one by one. The gap between the caliper and the motor is only about 1 mm. We install a torque arm because the motor output is high. Loosen the stainless hose band screw. We put on heat shrink tube for scratch protection. Lock it with axle nuts. We will now begin replacing the motor connector. Please remove the wire covering. Use nippers to remove the motor wire covering. Since it is tough, the covering is difficult to remove. Put on the XT150 housing cover. Fill the XT150 male terminal cup with solder. Insert the wire. Put on the female connector. We will use a vise. Insert it by pushing it in one notch over the edge. You'll hear a crisp sound. It worked well. Please use a hot melt glue gun to seal the back. For the front motor, use a red connector. Let's start testing the dual controllers. These are two high output controllers of 48 volts, 1000 watts, 38 amper each, XT150 connectors. The motor output is 1000 watts. What do you mean by using a bullet connector? Bullet connectors have a lower allowable current. Connector replacement is recommended. Bullet connectors are inadequate. Please remove the wire insulation. Attach the XT150 connector housing. Cut a 5 mm diameter heat shrink tube a little bit. Insert the cut tube onto the phase wire. Allow the solder to penetrate the controller phase wire. Fill the XT150 connector cup with solder. Attach the phase wire. Attach the male connector. Please hang it over the vise little by little, front and back. It should go in with one notch. Yes, it went in well. The rear motor controller connector is made in black. The XT90 connector is connected to the battery. Cut the power cable one by one. There may be residual electricity remaining. If you cut them simultaneously, a short circuit will occur. I will cut it short because the wire is a little long. This should be sufficient. First, insert the heat shrink tube. Solder the XT90 connector. It's best to make the surface smooth. Heat the pre-inserted heat shrink tube to protect the connector. The polarity of the connector is protected, so soldering can be done safely. The controller connector exchange is complete. How to make an XT90Y cable. As there are two controllers, two female XT90 connectors are required. Good soldering output is necessary. As the wire is thick, a high output soldering iron is needed. Heat enough to allow the solder to permeate. Insert the heat shrink tube. Use a heat gun to heat the tube. To check for connector connection errors, place the multimeter in continuity test mode. Check the positive electrode. Connection confirmed normal. Check the negative electrode. Connection confirmed normal. Production is successfully completed. XT90 and XT60. The XT90 connector is connected to the battery. The XT60 is used as a charging connector. Use a wire stripper to remove the wire insulation. Peel the wire in the middle. Peel the insulation of the XT60 connector wire. Solder the wire connected to the XT60 connector. Heat sufficiently to allow the solder to permeate deeply. Use insulation tape to wrap the cable. We have made a Y cable to connect the battery, charging, and dual controller. It's complete. Starting the controller test. Connect the throttle connector. The motor and controller have been connected. The preparation for the front motor operation test is complete. We now begin the operation test. Rough noise occurs because the phase is not matching. Connect green connectors to start motor phase learning. Operate the throttle to make the motor rotate in the correct direction for 20 seconds or more. If the rotation is smooth, disconnect the green learning connector. Learn the rear motor in the same way. Remove all green connectors and test at full power. Both motors are operating normally at the same time. See you again in the next video.